three.
Fighters ready? Ready?
Umbar's goal getting off some good strikes. Gina Inyong looking at the more confident in the grappling. Lumbang Gol in the blue, Inyong in the red. Lumbang Gol did say she wanted to draw Gina into the latter round. Oh, and catches with a stunning right hand! And there's a right hand from Gina, 2-2 now!
That was beautifully timed as Inyong is coming in. Lumbang Gol caught her with a counterpunch.
Lumbang Gol with some really nasty technique here. Did you see the little side kick to the lead knee? Nasty stuff from Lumbang Gol. High side kick from Gina Inyong. We are seeing some wushu styling here in the second round.
You can see they're both choosing to stay inside that kicking range, but only when Gina chooses to engage, and she really closes the distance very quickly. And Lumbang Gol's timing those very well as she's coming in.
Two exquisite right hands down the center from Gina Inyong. Now the corking knees and a takedown from Inyong.
Beautifully done. Had the weight shifted to one side, it goes to the other and ends up inside control. Now she's trying to crucifix the left hand of Lumbang Gol.
Inyong did say, look out for the arm bar. That's how I'm going to submit her. Cuts a hip in here inside control. Not where Lumbang Gol wants to be. Dominant position for Gina Inyong.
Inyong will try to pin down the left arm of Lumbang Gol and drop some elbows, but a big bridge from Lumbang Gol, but not enough to reverse the position. See, there it is. She pins down that arm, and now here come the shots.
And listen to this massive crowd get behind their own Gina Inyong. Cuts the hips in again. Side control. Ground and pound from Gina. Lumbang Gol, no place to go. She's getting beaten on here. Hammer fist strikes. Now strikes to the forehead. Referee right on top of the action. Is Gina going to beat her? Is she going to score a TKO? Yes! 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 Listen to that ovation.
Check this out. She did perfectly what I was talking about. Once she had the left arm pinned in between her legs, there was nowhere to go. She had an underhook on the right side, completely secure the position and just let the hammer fist rain down.
Gina Inyong!
Back your corner.
It's the Philippines versus Australia. Ballingong's classy wushu against McLaren's rugged grappling. McLaren is a genius at locking on the rear naked choke.
Ready?
Ballingong has 8 first round finishes. We're set for 3 by 5 minute rounds. The Aussie in the blue, the Filipino in the red. Jab 2 early on here from Lightning Reese McLaren.
Kevin Ballingong is known for that lightning fast front kick that seems to come out of nowhere. Just how long until he throws it?
McLaren had an 8-week camp on Australia's Gold Coast up north in Queensland, said he worked on bridging the gap between his striking to his takedowns. Jab 2 again and a double jab from Reese McLaren.
Reese McLaren immediately starts with the taunting. Oh, what a right hand!
Beautiful right hand from Ballingong. McLaren in trouble. Here comes Ballingong. Could it be the GoDaddy knockout of the night on the way? Ballingong driving in the left hand, driving in the right hand, and McLaren reaches up, pulls him down. He's got to control the posture. He's got to stop the ground and pound.
Those are some huge shots thrown by Ballingong, but what heart by McLaren to hang in there. Olivier jumps in.
And Irene! The Filipino brings the house down. What a crazy victory.
Out of nowhere, the right hand comes. The ground and pound swarms on top of McLaren, avoided a lot of shots, but took a lot in the process.
Kevin Ballingong!
Judge, Judge.
Is it going to be the GoDaddy knockout of the night? Or will we see a GoDaddy knockout of the night here between Mia Smell and Edward Kelly? Inside leg early from Mia Smell. Queen Kumai and judo stylist. If Kelly knocks out the Cambodian, this place will go bananas. Oh, there's the left. Oh!
Martial arts world champions of the one championship roster. Two of them in the circle at the moment. Let's see if we have some more pepper, some more get up and go with the Super Saruta. Body punches here from Pascio. Saruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corking knees into the thighs. So Pascio turns the champion.
Saruta placing the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pascio.
Shot from Pascio, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Saruta. Pascio trying to stab himself in center circle here. Cross out the jab. Saruta does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pascio. Reddening on the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pascio, courtesy of the leg kicks from the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pascio. Again, Mitch gets in quick and scores, gets out.
This is the Pascio we expected to see. We want to see those fast blitzes, bop, bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stopped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful stick kick there from Saruta. Landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown, but now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pascio starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
He's a hand-right counter from Pascio. After a really nice left hook from Saruta, under 3 minutes remains. Penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pascio. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pascio. Now all he's doing now is he's just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakay athlete. Oh,
come on! Freaking irate! Manila goes into a meltdown!
Look at this head kick. I think that reminds me of the Edward Kelly against Bob Mounds, like knee/head kick, just starching. Beautiful head kick, the walk off KO.
Joshua Pascio.
Joshua Pascio is once again a world champion. Team Lakay once again has a world title belt in its possession.
Round three.
Fight!
from Aoki. There's that flying knee again. That is getting timed very well. But look at this. He's able to shrug.
Oh, and the knee to the head as well. Foalyang has got Shinya in trouble. Punches to the head. The noise behind me is deafening. Foalyang looking for the finish. Shinya Aoki is standing very, very closely, watching hard. Nothing's coming back from Aoki. We're only half a minute into this third round. It's perpetual motion from the Filipino. And it is all over. We have a new one championship lightweight title holder. And his name is Eduard Foalyang.
Steve, he did it! Eduard Foalyang shocks the world with an upset victory to become the new one lightweight world champion. Quite possibly the biggest upset we've ever had in one championship.
Well, I tell you, there were a few people who could have seen it coming. Rich Franklin, give us your thoughts.
I don't even know what to say at this point in time. It's unbelievable, you know? Foalyang had those high-risk moves, the spinning kicks, the spinning, and he actually attempted that jump knee once or twice earlier in the fight. And you knew that if it landed, it was going to pay off for him, and it paid off right there.
You can see from the replay, Aoki offering nothing in return, defending as best he could, but nothing was coming back, and that was the deciding factor in Yuji Shimada's decision to stop the fight. And the tears of emotion, so apparent. It's been a long time coming for Eduard Foalyang, but his moment has arrived, and the Philippines are enjoying it just as much as he is.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 41 seconds in the third round. For your winner, and new one lightweight world champion, Eduard!